Hi everybody, welcome to What's Popping. If you're new here, do not forget to subscribe to my channel, give this video a thumbs up, and let's get right into the video. Now today I want to talk about No Money and whether or not is No Money being sabotaged. Now ever since she dropped her really amazing banger song called Wild Side, and I just want to say I love the song. And I do not have an issue with Cardi B being on the song, but I did peep that a couple of people felt like the song, the verse that Cardi B did was indeed unnecessary, and that the song would have done well with or without Cardi B. But we all know that Cardi B does have some sort of charting power, and that probably did help the song chart to number 14 on the Billboard Hot 100. Now I just want to talk about briefly as to whether or not is No Money being sabotaged by either her label or whoever in the industry. Now I just want to start off by saying the song did incredibly well, and it did debut on number 14, like I said, on the Billboard 100 in its first week. And in the beginning the song seemed to be doing relatively well, but currently it has dropped like 40 places down on the charts, which makes me wonder what is really going on. Now the rollout of Wild Side has been nothing but chaotic, to say the least. First it was Cardi B throwing a tantrum after fans started telling her that they're not necessarily pleased with her verse on Wild Side and that they felt like it was unnecessary, and she threw a tantrum by going on a rant on Twitter and saying, "Well, from this day forward, I won't promote or talk about the song and tell No Money team to release a version without my vocal. Yay, now your wish and desires came true. Make sure you stream it though. Don't have me making calls for no reason." Now, the response from Cardi B had me feeling like she was treating Money's feature like a charity case. Maybe she felt like she was doing No Money a favor and it wasn't necessarily a collaborative effort. Which, if we're being honest, it probably wasn't, because No Money did mention that Cardi B wanted to be on the song so bad. It was more so a last minute thing, and Cardi B ended up sending her verse and she ended up being on the song. So I guess it's safe to say that Cardi B probably liked the song like she said she did, but she probably treated it like a charity case, and she probably looked at it as, listen, I have the power and I'm gonna use the power that I have to help your song. I feel like that's what it was. Well, that's just one part of the whole rollout. The second part gets even more chaotic, because having your song being blocked from your fans streaming it in certain regions, that definitely will stop your bag, and that gives a bad look on you as an artist. Well, that's exactly what happens with No Money. Everything from this point just seems to be acting against No Money's favor. It seems as if someone is indeed trying to sabotage No Money and her bag and her image and her music. Well, I just want to say it's very difficult for one to sabotage a career of a woman who indeed has the talent, the drive, the energy, and everything that she needs to succeed in the industry. She can dance, she can sing, she's very present on stage. What is it that No Money can't do? Absolutely nothing. So it starts making me wonder at this point, is the label trying to sabotage No Money? The answer here I cannot give, but I'll give you a couple of reasons why I think that's very much possible. To start off, No Money did mention that for Wild Side, she had to take her own money to shoot the video. So that simply means that the label did not give her a budget at all. Or I don't know if they did give her a budget to begin with, because she did mention that she is the only one that funded the shooting of the video. And let's just say, if you did watch the video was so amazing. And for a video that she supported herself, or she financed herself, that is a really amazing video. The choreography was on point. Everything about that video was perfect, and I felt like it's one video that something that I've never necessarily seen in the industry, or something that I haven't seen a lot of people do. It was really beautiful, and I commend her for that. Now, One would have assumed that when you see the visuals, you would have probably assumed that the label did have her backing, which wasn't the case. And that makes me think maybe they don't really want to invest in her as much as they want to. So they do probably want to invest in her, but maybe they don't. Maybe that's the issue. Maybe they don't want her to succeed, or maybe they feel like she won't succeed. But I know Nomani indeed does have the fans backing, and we all know based on Motivation that did incredibly well 2 years ago, we all know that the fans really love Nomani and the fans want Nomani to succeed. So yes, Nomani does have the fans backing. Which leaves the question, why is it that it is only the label that does not want Nomani to succeed? Or why is it that it looks like it is the label that doesn't want to invest in Nomani? Now, I saw on T Ash Miracle on YouTube saying that it is probably also because of colorism. They do not want to promote a talented dark-skinned black woman in comparison to her other light-skinned counterparts or her other non-black counterparts. They are probably getting the promotion they need, and when it comes to Nomani, it seems like they don't want to invest in her as much as they do invest in her other label mates. Well, that's just what I think. Next up, I want to talk about the song being blocked or being removed or being unable for fans to play the song on streaming platforms such as Apple Music and Spotify. Now, I just think that that's just another way in which they're trying to sabotage Nomani. Because let's be honest, that was really reckless in my opinion. I feel like that's a problem or an issue that could have easily been avoided. It doesn't usually happen, so why does it have to happen to Nomani to begin with? And a couple of fans were worried. You know, one person on Twitter said, "I feel bad for you, but that's the Cardi effect." Another person went on to say, "I'm so tired of people sabotaging you. You deserve better, girl." Another person said, "Leave RCA as soon as you can, please." Another thing I want to say, Nomani had a performance on the 20th with Jimmy Fallon, and she ended up not going because the performance got cancelled last minute. But for some reason, Camila Cabello ended up being the one that performs instead. I'm not sure if it's on the same day or days later, but that had me thinking, what in the hell is that? Why would that happen, and why would her label allow for that to happen? Clearly, there's something in the industry which I want to mention, probably the colorism or probably the racism that is going on. That's probably the biggest reason why they don't want to push Nomani. They would rather invest more in her other female white or light-skinned counterparts because they just want that to be what's out there and not Nomani. And that's what I feel like is going on. Something I want to add, I saw a thread on Twitter by Kid Uzi, and he explains why he thinks that Nomani is being intentionally sabotaged by RCA or Sony, to be specific. Now, I'm going to link down the link to his Twitter, and you can go through it and read through his explanation as to why he feels that Nomani is being intentionally, and I mean intentionally, sabotaged by Sony, to be specific. Now, the operation Let's Sabotage Nomani is hard at work at ensuring that this song does not reach its full capacity, because for the past 48 hours at which the song has been, the fans have been unable to stream it. That indeed has been affecting Nomani's streaming numbers. And I really wish that the label cared about Nomani, because if you're going to sign someone, at least try and show you care for them. But clearly they don't. All I really can't wait to see is what Nomani is gonna do, because I think at one point she needs to realize where everything is going wrong, and if it is the label, she probably will have to leave. But that's just what I think. Leave a comment down below and tell me what you think about this video. Tell me if you feel like the label, to be specific, are the ones that are hard at work at ensuring that no money fails. Do leave a comment down below. Don't forget to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up. Bye.